It'd probably be like a sandwich, you know. So you grill the bottom, put some cheese on top, the hamburger, some Kalbi.
Some rice, some mac salad, some hamburgers, some eggs.
You know that orange stuff that Zippy's, you know the yellow orange thing that Zippy's has? Those in the zip pack, the weird yellow thing.
The tongs.
Why?
Because a lot of us are panties.
A mallet.
Why?
Because we're hammers.
Let it go, let it go. Can't hold it back anymore. Here I am. Turn away and slam the door. Let it go. That's all I know.
Welcome back to Cover 2, Hawaii High School Football Weekly. Postponed BIIF Championship Tournament semifinals will take place this weekend, where teams will avoid letting go of 2014, especially number 6 Hilo. Undefeated Vikings have won 18 straight league games, and much of that success can be credited to one of the most dynamic and best names in the state, Tristan Spikes, senior running back with over 8 yards per carry and 11 scores.
He runs with an aggression and a downhill style that I haven't coached before. To try and describe it into words may be selling it short, but he gets yards on every play. And that's a difficult thing, blocking assignments, missed blocks, blitzes. He just is able to find and get downhill. He's strong, he's fast, and he's very, very aggressive on his cuts, and his vision has really improved over the last 3 years, and I think that's what makes him such a special player.
Over in the Big Islands Division II, top-seeded Kamehameha Hawaii will look to punch a ticket to the league final facing Honoka'a, while on the other side of the bracket, Konawaena will continue their quest for a fourth straight league title. But as Coach Thane of Sports Viz tells us, standing in the way will be a tough Hawaii Prep Academy squad that brings a two-way stud who is garnering much-deserved attention.
HPA senior tight end Dean Nikki Pleshi has been a two-way starter for 3 years. However, with last year's D2 Offensive Player of the Year Bobby Lum now at Southern Oregon, Nikki is the focus of the Kamakani offense. He has 59 receptions, 670 yards, and 7 TDs. Now, Nikki excels in the classroom as well. He's being recruited by schools such as Cal, Stanford, and Harvard. The last time these teams met, he faced off with fellow Cal recruit, junior cornerback Luka Vartek. The two had quite a battle, and we expect a repeat performance on Friday.
With Big Island Cookies packed in the carry-on, headed back to Oahu now, where the Final Four, the OIA's D2, will be playing for much more than a spot in the league final. Winners this weekend will also claim the league's only two spots into the state tournament. Radford, the only team of the bunch to have claimed an OIA D2 title, will face Pearl City, gunning after a third trip to the state tourney in 4 years. And in the other semifinal, top-ranked and undefeated Nanakuli, along with the state's leading D2 rusher, Makaila Haina Horsewill, facing off with heavy underdogs Kalani. But as Sam Spangler tells us on campus, these Falcons are no stranger to rewriting a story.
Hey, that's right, Rob. It was hopelessness, one of the worst emotions in the human psyche. That was the Kalani football team during their lost decade. You see, the Falcons went 2-80 from 2001 to 2010. One of the players on those teams, Dustin Kimura, turned his frustration with losing on the gridiron into piling up wins in the UFC. Now the Falcons have turned their frustrations into turning the corner. Back-to-back playoff appearances in the OIA's Division II. Let's take a trip on campus along Kalaniana Ole Highway and see how Kimura's pulling on his dreadful days as a Falcon to help pull him out of a rut in the octagon.
The beauty of sports is not, you know, you talk about the win-loss record, it's not necessarily the win-loss, it's the relationships you build. And that's our proudest moment, to see our athletes succeed in life, such as Dustin. I mean, I'll take 100 Dustins on a team any day. You know, he was a hard worker and he came to work, you know, and he tried to push his teammates to be better.
Despite Dustin's best push, he couldn't lead the Falcons to victories. Kalani was an anemic 1-23 while the diamond was cutting his teeth as a running back and safety from 2004 to 2006.
When I was in school, Kalani wasn't, we weren't great at all, but I played football because I loved the game.
Life works in mysterious ways. The endless string of losses during his career on the gridiron can now help Kimura navigate adversity in the octagon. After an impressive 10-0 run to start his professional career, Dustin has now dropped two of his last three bouts.
I think, you know, it's almost just as important to learn how to lose and how to bounce back after losses, you know, like in life, life's lessons in sports. There's good times, bad times. You know, hopefully the lessons that he learned are perseverance, just keep working hard, and just keep grinding.
It's one thing to lose and, you know, take it like a poor sport, and there's one way to come back to practice, come back to the gym, and, you know, look at what you did wrong, because obviously you made some mistakes, and how to build off of that and correct them.
If he needs help building his turnaround, look no further than his alma mater. In their last 2 years, the Falcons are 10-8.
if you would have told me back then that they're gonna actually win more than one game, I wouldn't have believed you. I'm real proud of them and excited, and just, you know, real happy to see that, you know, the program has grown a lot.
And in another few years, the Falcons and Dustin see themselves in a similar spot, carrying a title belt for Kea'au.
Dustin, the Diamond Kimura!
Oh, absolutely. I'm not in the sport to, you know, just win sometimes, lose sometimes. I'm here to be the best and be the greatest.
Winning the state, Division II state championship. They have it in them. You know, it takes time and it takes effort, it takes coaching. But if I looked in the crystal ball 5 years from now, I'd say they'd be state champs.
Falcons will look to grab their first playoff win in school history Saturday night in Nanakuli. Kimura will hit the octagon again December 13th against former Olympic gold medalist Henry Cejudo. For Cover 2, Sam Spangler.